afternoon. Thank you for coming to my talk. First of all, this presentation is online, and there are some examples, but I won't have enough time to present them, so we can try them at home later. Let's start with what's Flatpak. Flatpak is a next generation technology for building and distribution applications on Linux. It's focused on applications as an app store on iOS and Android. It includes sandbox, which is gradually improved. And there is also a social aspect, because if you publish your applications directly, for example, by publishing them on FlatHub, there is shorter distance between developers and users, and the feedback should be much more effective. I will give a few examples regarding my project, which focuses on web-based streaming services, Spotify and 28 others, and integrates them with Linux desktop. It's open source, and the technologies involved are GTK, Chromium Embedded Framework, Vala, Python, and JavaScript. During development, this is the application. Basically, what it does, it runs a web interface of a streaming service, injects JavaScript to inspect the metadata, and it then provides extra features such as lyric fetching, media player interface, multimedia keys, and so on. During the development, I faced many issues with fragmentation of Linux. The problem is that the independent software vendors cannot target something which is could be called standard Linux. There was old effort Linux start on base, but I don't think it's relevant anymore. The problem is that there are various distributions, they include various versions of libraries and various package formats. Typically, you need to build one package per distribution because a package often changes names, gets split or merged, and so on. With Flatpak, you can build one package, one cross-distribution package. The app is running in a sandbox, which is shielded from the jungle on the host OS. You choose the runtime which provides the user the user space for an application, and the application is run with the same runtime when it's run by the users. Moreover, you don't need to rebuild Flatpak for new distro releases, so it's much, lot of more convenient. Novella is written in Vala, which is a nice language with C-like syntax. The Vala code is translated to C code and then compiled. There are Vala API files, which describe the integration with C and the G object libraries, which is very handy, because I can use the GNOME stack with nice syntax. Every release of Vala fixes bugs and improves the API files, which is great. On the other hand, it is sometimes done in a backward incompatible way. So I ended up with conditional compilation, if Vala this version, then this, and so on. And I kept local copies of the WebP files. And of course, I didn't keep them updated, and I didn't receive the new bug fixes. With Flatpak, I can target Vala from SDK, one specific version, or I can build Vala from source and include bug fixes and patches. I dropped conditional compilation and removed the local WebP files. I finally had free hands to start a major refactoring. I extended unit test and run them at Valgrind. During that, I found a few bugs in Vala and reported them or sent merge requests. And the bugs were fixed promptly, and I could include them in my Flatpak and benefit from that immediately. I also test my application with Vala from Git master branch for regressions. Another issue was that bug fixes weren't always reported. Each distribution has a unique set of bugs, and there is not just enough human resources to fix them all. So as an app developer, I could try to find a workaround or just suggest users to wait until the next release of Redis distribution, which is not very great. With Flatpak, I have full control of the dependencies. I can add patches to fix bugs, and I can even override the libraries from the runtime if it isn't necessary. Another limitation was that some libraries are not present in all distributions, or they have optional features which are not always enabled. So you are limited to common subset. You may need to disable some optional features of your applications depending on the distribution, which is quite sad because I spent a lot of time developing even the optional features. With Flatpak, again, I have full control of dependencies. I can bundle extra libraries I need, and I can make sure that my application provides all features I developed. Novella used to use WebKit GTK as a web rendering engine. The problem was that whereas the development of the web stack was very fast, WebKit GTK was updated in distributions very slowly. It's much better nowadays, but still, it was a problem in the past. Moreover, users wanted to get rid of Flash plugin for audio playback, but the media source extension, which is needed for flashless playback, was experimental and disabled in common WebKit GTK builds. With Flatpak, I could use always up-to-date WebKit GTK, and I could enable the experimental features. However, it was still not enough, because the MSE support in WebKit was incomplete, and for example, Google Play Music didn't work with that. Flash support was also buggy. And furthermore, there was no support for Widevine, which is needed by Spotify and Amazon Music. So I switched to Chromium Embedded Framework, which is not available in any distribution as a library. I don't wonder, because there are no stable releases, and it's quite a mess. But it works, and it supports media source extensions and Widevine. And finally, after years of struggling, I could achieve the goal that most Novella apps no longer use Flash for audio playback. I think there is only one app left. Common approach to somehow work around the fragmentation is to target all distributions, add workarounds for bugs in the hope that you can drop them in 2 years. You are disconnected from the platform development because, yeah, there is new release of GTK, but I can use it in 2 years. And also there is lesser incentive to report bugs and fix them because there is no immediate benefit. With Flatpak, I can use the latest library stack. I can benefit from new features and bug fixes. I can even help with the development by reporting bugs. If the bug is fixed, I can immediately apply the patch in my Flatpak. And even better, I can fix the bugs and send my patches upstream. So maybe there are some people who heard of Flatpak for the first time. So there's a gentle introduction. Flatpak platforms provide basic libraries and Unix tools. They are shared between applications to save disk space and memory. They are maintained by skilled people, so you can expect some degree of quality and security assurance. The platforms are mounted under the user prefix in the sandbox. They are runtime dependency of the applications and are automatically installed. Common platforms are Free Desktop, GNOME, and KDE. but there are also platforms which are based on the distributions. I will skip this. SDKs are basically platforms extended with compilers and other developer tools, such as C header files, package config files, and so on. SDKs and platforms usually come in a pair, so there is FreeDesktop SDK, GNOME SDK, KDE SDK. Flatpak SDKs are build-time dependency, so only developers need to install them, but not users. And SDKs are mounted under the user's prefix in the sandbox. By default, the sandbox is very limited, and you need to set explicit permissions, for example, for file system access, access to X server VLAN, network access. This is mostly temporary, and the long-term goal is to get rid of the dangerous permissions and switch to portals. Portals are trusted DEB services, which run on the host and are called from the sandbox. Actions of the portals are confirmed by the users, so he is in charge, what is happening. There are portals for opening, saving files, printing, taking screenshots, and so on. Portals are also used for screen sharing in VLAN and are also by snap packages. So, finally, I will skip the last section, which is development in sandbox. The benefit of that is that you develop in the same environment your application will run in, so it should be easier to reproduce bugs. The basic approach could be to just launch a bash session in the sandbox and to run configure make all, whatever you need. Or you can use GNOME Builder or KDevelop, which contain a certain degree of Flatpak support. For example, in this screenshot, you can see GNOME Builder with demo application depending on GNOME platform, and you can see the typical actions build, rebuild. You can also export a Flatpak bundle, and you can run the application, and it just magically works. However, I don't use GNOME Builder. I use Nuvla CDK, Core Developer Kit, which is basically a Flatpak, which contains all dependencies I need for Nuvla, but without Nuvla. The benefit is that if I need to debug some desktop integration in different distribution, I have easy setup of my environment. I just install the Flatpak, execute this command, and I can hack right away. I don't need to install dependencies on the host OS and so on. There is also Nuvla IDK, which is used to develop the web app integration scripts. The benefit is that the script maintainers don't need to build Nuvla or Lonvala and whatever. I also include Nuvla SDK if you help the scripts written in Python or Bash. So all the script maintainers need to do is to install the Flatpak, run the Flatpak, and type Nuvla SDK new project, edit JSON file, JavaScript file in editor, and that's all. The final Flatpaks. I built one Flatpak per each application because that way they can be run side by side independently. The builds are fast because Nuvla and all dependencies are already pre-built in a base Flatpak, and it is just copied in the clean sandbox and is not built again. And then the Flatpak builder just adds these files and that's it. It's really fast. Because of that, I can publish Flatpaks whenever I fix a bug, and I got really good feedback that the users like that the big bugs are fixed really fast and they can get a new Flatpak in a few days instead of the months like in the common distributions. I also use Circle continuous integration to check the project with Novella projects with Novella ADK. There are also some drawbacks of Flatpak packaging. You need to maintain the libraries in your manifests. So I wrote a script which helped me to update manifests with the latest versions of libraries. It takes version information from this public API, and it's quite good. Of course, not all applications can run in a sandbox because of missing functionality. For that, you just need to talk to Flatpak developers and explain your needs, and they can improve the portals or add new portals. Another issue is the poor command-line experience. For example, in order to get track information for Novella, with normal package you could write only Novella CTL track info, but with Flatpak you need to write this long command, or you can create alias. And there is a new limiting factor on the host OS, and that's the version of Flatpak and the portals, because in older distributions there is older version of portals and there are not all features you may need. In conclusion, without Flatpak, Novella would be stuck with Flash plugin for audio playback, or probably discontinued. Flatpak provides me with stable platform I can optimize for and rely on, cross-distribution delivery, full control over dependencies and quality, I can enable all features I developed, and by delivering the applications directly to users, there is better interaction and the bug reports and or feedback are more valuable and effective. That's all. Thank you for attention. And we can have questions.
For example, I already use Spotify, already packaged for Flatpak. Is there any benefit to switch, for example, to Novella and use that on Flatpak instead?
Well, you can look at the feature features. The question was whether there is any benefit to use Novella with Spotify instead of the Spotify application in Flatpak. And I think you need to... look at the Novella features and then you can decide whether these features could be tempting to use Novella or you are happy with Spotify as it is. If you don't need any of these features, you can... You don't get any benefit.
Thank you. Questions? Anyone else?
So, question. Okay. This is black. I don't like black. My desktop is not black. If I run this on my desktop, will it be black or green? Oh, great.
It will be black by default, but... the question was whether the user interface will be black on his desktop, and yeah, it doesn't look now, but you can change the theme, and by default it's dark, but you can choose lighting.
Well, I'm not talking about the dual application, I'm talking about Flatpak and its access to my preferences for GTK. Themes.
You can install themes for Flatpak and then Flatpak will use it automatically.
But by default it won't be able to see my themes and my preferences for my desktop.
It will see it by default, and recent versions of DevConf software will automatically install extension for your desktop theme, so you will have the same desktop theme on your desktop or in the Flatpak applications automatically.
So, maybe I add something. So basically it works the way that it does not have a mic.
What?
There are mic for that and you
please.
basically it works the way that the application of the GTK running in the sandbox is not exposed to the system theming or theme, because you can't, the theme you have installed in the system is pretty much optimized for the version of the GTK that is in your system. And the GTK in the runtime will be different and leads to different results. So, but basically what you can do, like the most popular themes for GTK are also packaged as extensions for runtimes, and then that author of that extension makes sure that that theming works pretty well with the runtime. And when you install the application, for example from BlendHub, it looks at the theme you have installed in the system, and if you find the same in FlatHub, it installs it as an extension to the runtime. So I'm not sure how many themes are supported, like 10, 15 maybe, the most popular ones. But it's not like you can, it supports any theme you can find on the internet. Theoretically, it could be possible, but then like if you expose the system theme and render it with a different version of GTK, may lead to unexpected results.
Question was whether the question was whether Novella works offline. The answer is no. It's only a smart web about the web interface. There were other projects such as Tomahawk player, I think, which I don't know. Maybe the Spotify Flatpak, the original. Supports maybe offline listening, but I'm not sure. Novella definitely doesn't support offline listening and even need to be online.
Do you have time for one or two questions if someone wants to fire me? So, okay, thanks a lot.